Among the busy people working for Maine Senator Susan Collins, you'll find a high school junior. Kate Bork won a prestigious internship to work within the senator's office, and she's only the second student from Portland High School to have such an experience.
These students aren't just getting coffee. They're setting up futures, potentially, in the world of politics. We sat down with two who've gone through the program and with Eric Moynihan with Jobs for Maine's Graduates, a program in many Maine schools.
He explains how students can take advantage of opportunities like this and how it helps them grow beyond their classroom education.
It's the notion that students getting out into the community, establishing relationships with businesses, just benefits them greatly as they move through their plans.
This is really only year two of doing an internship with Senator Collins' office. And Sophie, you were the first in this program.
Yeah.
What was that like interning for her office?
It was a little intimidating. At first, I'm the only high school student in a group of college students and then people who actually worked there. So it was a little bit intimidating. So I really had to make sure that I had to like make sure that respect was earned so that I would show that high schoolers are able to do these jobs, because there is kind of a connotation that high schoolers aren't able to do as much as high school, as college level students, even though we're like 2 years apart. But I was able to fully gain everyone's respect and able to do everything that the college students was do, which is really, really nice.
What sort of things were you doing in the office? I mean, I assume you weren't just getting people coffee.
No. So we were answering phone calls from constituents. I started my internship a few weeks after President Trump was elected, which is undoubtedly one of the craziest times to be working in a politician's office. So the phone's ringing off the hooks. That's all I did for the first about few months, actually, is just answer calls from constituents, talk with constituents in person just to address all of their issues that they had. And then as time went on, I started answering letters and such to anything that would help the office run.
And you're a senior this year. You're graduating in May, and you want to get into political science?
Yes, I want to major in political science with a concentration in business management, so I'm able to work in a political office and I'm older, maybe, you know, manage a politician's campaign or something along those lines.
Kate, you're just getting started in this internship. You've been three times now. What's your goal through this?
I think my goal is honestly just to kind of understand more how an office runs and like understand how it's not, the senator is not the only person working. There's so many people working behind the scenes for her campaign and just for her in general. And I just think it's really interesting to learn about all those different jobs and everything that goes into being a senator of the United States.
Was that something that was kind of shocking to you to see how many people were working behind her?
Yeah, definitely. I honestly didn't really understand or realize that she had an office in Portland. I was just assuming she had one in Washington, D.C. But it's really interesting just seeing how, like, just how many calls even come in every day when I'm there and how many letters she gets and just how many people have issues they either want to address or issues that they would like help solving. Yeah.
How do you see this internship shaping your future?
I definitely think it'll help getting into college. I'm kind of thinking about doing the Senate Page program that Sophie did this past summer. And I just think it's a really great way to like make connections with different people who work with politicians. So. Yeah.
I'm glad you mentioned the Page program because you actually, aside from the internship that you did with her office, you then in the summertime went down to D.C. and actually worked in the Page program. How was that helpful to kind of continue your learning experience?
Well, I mean, the Page program basically is 30 high school students from all across the U.S. They're all working in the Senate, sponsored by different senators from their state. And that was undoubtedly one of the coolest things that I've ever done. It really helped really solidify what I want to do in the future because I was on the floor helping all the senators and stuff. You know, if you ever watch C-SPAN, I get all the senators their waters and run errands and stuff like that. So I was able to really see how the Senate works and how politics is really like up close, which I think was really, really fascinating. Definitely helped, you know, solidify the idea that I really do want to go into politics.
Eric, Jobs for Maine graduates, that's something that is in schools all over Maine.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it so important to get young people involved in the process so early on?
Yep, Jobs for Maine's graduates in over 75 programs in the state of Maine, servicing 7,000 students from middle school all the way through high school. And now we have college retention programs at a number of the community colleges and Thomas College. So the JMG program is essentially about, it's a classroom that teaches career preparation, community engagement, financial literacy. But the part that I do most with all students from Portland, not just the JMG class, is the career preparation part, the connection to the community. I mean, we're just in an unbelievable situation here in Portland. We're a campus right in the middle of the city, the biggest city in Maine. Businesses are all around us, all willing to contribute to the education of the students. And so this year alone, we've got 45 juniors doing internships with 27 different businesses. That's up almost by 20 from last year. And so, you know, the goal is to ideally get every single junior to do an internship. We're at the Portland Symphony Orchestra, the Portland Museum of Art, the Children's Museum of Maine, Maine Metro, Portland Metro, the YMCA, Casco Bay Artisans. I mean, the list goes on and on of businesses that are just really willing to contribute and help prepare our students for the future after high school.
And their internship lasts an entire semester.
Stay with us, back with more right after this.